Hey guys, this is Oldark, and I'm going to show you how to get started using Enhanced Portals 3. The materials listed on the book on your screen is the minimum required to connect two portals using a dialing device for the smallest portals possible. First thing you're going to want to make is a dimensional bridge stabilizer. It's a multi-block structure. It requires two levels of six blocks each at a minimum size or larger. And here's the recipe for it. It's four blocks of iron, four ender pearls, and a diamond. You only need to do this at least twice to make the minimum size, because each one is six blocks. And once you've built your structure, you can pull out any kind of wrench. Buildcraft wrenches work great. And just right-click it, and that will initialize it. Your stabilizer will need power. And the other thing you'll need is these location cards. The location cards are made from paper, iron, and some lapis, and it makes a pretty good amount of cards. You get 16 from crafting one time. And when you put your location cards here into this slot, it will change to location set, and then that will link any portal you create using one of those cards will draw power from this dimensional stabilizer. Now, to make the portals themselves, you're going to need these portal frames. Now, portal frames use a block of quartz, four iron, and four smooth stone. You'll need to do this recipe at least three times because you'll need 12 portal frames. And the block of quartz, the easiest way to make it is with four nether quartz. There are some alternate recipes. You can pull it up in NEI to see what they are. And once you have your frames, you're going to need to turn two of them into portal controllers just by adding a diamond. You're also going to want to turn two into network interfaces by adding an ender pearl. Now, I'd recommend upgrading your network interfaces to dialing devices by taking your interface and adding a diamond to it. That will let you specify which portal you want yours to connect to and to change it every time you turn it on. Now, to make the portals, you're going to build the frame out of portal frames, as you might expect, and you want to have your portal controller and your dialing device as part of the frame. Now, once the frame is finished, you take one of the location cards from your stabilizer, right-click the portal controller, and then that will activate your portal. Now, to set it up, you'll need to right-click on your controller with your wrench, and you can set a unique identifier. This is the address of your portal. You have nine choices, and you can select from any of these down here. They can be used multiple times. It's just that's how you determine which portal you want to connect to. And public or private. If you're using the dialing devices, you want to set it to public. They can't connect to private networks. And you can just not tell people your combination if you want to keep it a secret. There's a lot of different options you can have here. And then to dial a portal, right-click your dialing device and hit manual entry. Now here you type in the address of the portal you want to go to. And you can choose to save it. If you do, you name the address and you can set the particles and the textures that you would like it to use. Or you can just dial it directly. And there you go, your portal's turned on. And just hop through. Now, this is just to show that your portals don't have to be the normal horizontal shape. They can be vertical. And one of the modules you can add to it will put feather fall on anyone who goes through one. And also, you can have portals that aren't shaped normal at all, like this one right here. Or this, which is the smallest size portal that you can walk through. And that's what the supply is listed in the book at the beginning of this video were for. It's just one controller, one dialing device, and four portal frames. Now, some of the peripherals you can add to this, you have three different transportation modules, one for fluid, one for items, and one for energy. And the way you use these is when you build your portal, you just attach them along the frame, as if they were just the same way you did your controller and your dialing device. They have to be part of the frame. And then as long as you have pipes or something hook up to them, anytime the portal is activated, They will transport items, fluid, or energy to the target portal as well. The target portal also has to have one of the modules. Another module you can have is the redstone module. This would just let you activate your portal with a redstone signal. And the module manipulator. What the module manipulator does is it lets you add various side effects, or mostly aesthetic things, to your portal. That would be these symbols here, or these items here, sorry. So you can have it prevent particles from coming out, give them random colors, make your portal quiet so you don't hear it activated. You can have things keep momentum when they go through. You can make your portal invisible. You can set the direction that someone will face when they step through it, or put feather fall on them. And what you do is you have to just build these modules, and you add them into your module manipulator along the edge of your portal. And that's about it. Thank you for watching.